Prime Minister Edi Rama announced today at the weekly meeting of co-governance with citizens that the deadline for allocating funds to universities will be postponed. The Democratic Party has engaged its deputies and experts for drafting a new law on higher education. The decision by the dentist's order to raise dental fees faces backlash in the Health Committee, where Minister Manastirliu was not present. Good evening. It's 6 o'clock on Wednesday, the 30th of January, 2019. Welcome to the English edition of Aura News. My name is Oliver, and I'm here to bring you the day's top stories from across the country, translated into English. Tonight, we turn our attention to the Education Minister, Bessa Shahini, whose presence at the media committee has sparked debate on student requirements. The Minister of Education saying she was opposed to proposals for legal changes in higher education, while affirming that all student requirements were addressed in discussions over the University Pact. Education Minister Shahini left the media committee while discussing law on higher education as it relates to students, but the chair of the committee considered this as a serious legal violation and an insult against MPs, stating, "Your scenario worked. It is embarrassing to leave the commission and to abandon the meeting. It is shameful for such a majority to behave in this way. I am glad that all citizens will now see what kind of minister Edi Rama has put in his government, what deputies work for him, and those whose only interests are to maintain governmental power. It is unconstitutional, it is illegal, and it is a grave offense to all of us. It is a shame that you let the students be so isolated. I will not only ask Edi Rama to refrain from provocations, but I will also inform the European Union delegation, along with embassies and officials in Brussels." Earlier today, the Minister of Education, Bessa Shahini, before the media commission, said she was against the proposal for legal changes in higher education, while MP Albana Boçi said that with these statements, the minister proved that she has not met the requirements set by students. She stated, "Considering all that we have seen from other countries, we do not consider it necessary that these changes be addressed through legal procedures, taking into account that even with the decision of the Council of Ministers, we have addressed two of the main issues raised by students for transparency and for representation on the administrative board," she said. After Albana Boçi asked the minister if her attitude towards the proposals were for or against, she received a positive response from the minister. However, Boçi continued to accuse her of not fulfilling her student requirements, stating, "You seem to accept that the University Pact has not met the requirements set by students. Why are you deceiving us by claiming that the pact has met these requirements? Why do you deceive the students? Right now, you yourself are saying that you are against some of the students' requests. I am glad that you accept that the students' requests have not been completed. It is in your honor to come out and to tell the students and professors that you cannot and did not meet with some of their requirements. You are accepting that the pact is only a farce," said Boçi. To which Shahini replied, "This pact has addressed student requirements and we do not need to make any further legal changes." Prime Minister Edi Rama, in his weekly meeting of co-governance, encouraged citizens to find out more about their rights through Albanians' platform shqipria.al. Amid administrative investigations, Rama stated that there were 643 disciplinary measures taken, while about 300 civil employees were dismissed from duty. Referring to the disbursement of funds to institutions of higher education, Prime Minister Rama announced that the postponement of the deadline beyond January 19th, as the government needs an accurate and up-to-date list of students, stating, "There is a problem with the disbursement of funds to the universities. We need accurate lists of all students, including their socioeconomic situations, and this takes time. Therefore, we requested a postponement of the deadline." Also, according to the Prime Minister, the deadline for the employment of students in his administration will be postponed, as many students have not been able to complete their documentation on time. "We will also postpone the deadline for the employment platform, as many students with grades 9 and 10 who want to apply for jobs in the administration have been unable to do so given the lack of necessary documentation required in the application. There are still about 800 jobs in the public administration available," said Rama. In the University Pact, the deadline for hiring students is May of this year. The Democratic Party has officially tossed its hat into the controversy surrounding the law on higher education. DPMPs and experts now getting engaged to draw up a new draft for the law on higher education. This engagement comes at a time when universities are in crisis, serving as a battlefield for student protests and a sanctuary to those who have continued their lessons. But losing Boçi's promise that he will annul the law when he comes to power is pushing the issue to the center of attention for the upcoming elections. At a time when the law on higher education has brought a crisis to university auditors, the Democratic Party has set up a working group to draft a new law as an alternative. The commission consists of deputies and experts and will be submitted to public consultation alongside interest groups. Deputy and members of the working group, Luciano Boçi, said that a special focus would be on how the students are treated, including their tuition fees. The new law that is expected to be issued by the Democratic Party's commission serves as a platform for the education of tomorrow, but Deputy Boçi says that if the government would reflect on the law on higher education, it could offer a new solution without wasting time. He stated, "It will be a product that is not political in nature, but rather solely academic and scholar. It is a law that is necessary and that simultaneously builds a future for the university, a future that includes research." Now to warnings from the International Monetary Fund. The Albanian government has repeatedly touted the investments made through the public-private partnership concessions, but new risks may be on the horizon. The IMF declares that this scheme carries a number of potential dangers with it. According to a recent report, the IMF draws attention on the changing value of investments and on the selection process of companies while underlining that it can be a risk to the economy. Former Finance Minister Arben Malaj urges policymakers to take measures and to listen to the recommendations of international institutions, stating, "These warnings are not taken into account, especially for short-term political or even non-political benefits. The consequences will place a burden on Albanian taxpayers, while the debt crisis poses a potential risk to the entire Albanian economy." Malaj suggests that there should have been more transparency regarding the country's financial situation. Another remark by the IMF called into question Albania's overdue obligations. According to the report, by September, the number of overdue obligations soars to 24.5 billion lek, or about 1.5% of domestic production. As for economic growth in the country, the forecast is now projected at 3.7%. Now to the request by the opposition. In the footsteps of Minister of Interior, the Minister of Health, Orgerta Manastirliu, did not respond to the requests of opposition MPs to participate in the Health Commission, DPMPs calling it a lack of seriousness. Opposition MPs called the Minister Manastirliu to come to the committee to discuss the increase of dental tariffs, but instead Manastirliu came Mira Rakatsoli, a representative of the deputy minister. DPMP Barth Spahia stated, "I urge the minister to show responsibility. The least she can do is come to the committee and take her responsibility seriously enough to clarify her positions and the positions of the institution she leads. Justifications for her busy agenda do not match the agenda of the Health Commission. It is ridiculous, as well as a sign of irresponsibility by her and the prime minister." The chair of the committee, Petrit Vasili, called the absence by the Minister of Health a lack of responsibility, but Socialist Party deputy Claudiana Spahiu claimed these comments were exaggerated. The Ministry of Health was interviewed by several officials, including Deputy Minister Mira Rakatsoli, the representative of the National Council on the Order of Dentists, Antoneta Njihorena, and George Kaya. The group from the Ministry of Health said that the decision was null and void and that they have been directed to the administrative court for not allowing its implementation. And that's the news from across the country today. Thank you for watching our English edition this evening. And be sure to join me again every Monday to Saturday at 6 p.m. for the latest news from Albania. Once again, on behalf of Aura News, thank you and have a good night.